Hello students, welcome back to online classes of Appa Public School. I am your computer science teacher Ranjita. So in the last class we have learned uses of computers. So computers, yes, what we have learned in that lesson? Yes, computers are used to type, listen to music, play games and many more. Yes, we can play game, okay, we can play games and we can also listen to music and we can also type. So, and also we learned that it is used in many places. Yes, computers are used in many places like bank, hospital, schools, airport, railway station. Okay, these are the simple example where computer is used. So next, today we will learn new lesson. Okay, the lesson will start with activity. What is that? We will see. Yes, warm up activity. What they have given? They have given that tick, right? The pictures of things that need electricity to work. Yes, we have to tick. Okay, among these we have to tick which machine works on electricity. Yes, we will see one by one. What is the first thing? Yes, it is alarm watch. After that, bicycle. Next, after bicycle, what they have given? Iron. Next is pencil with sharpener. Next is microwave or oven and scissor. They have given totally 6 machines. Okay, so we have to tick which machine works on electricity. So before starting the activity, let us learn what is use of these things. Alarm watch, we can watch time and we can keep alarm. So bicycle, for we can use bicycle. And also next is iron. Okay, iron is used for ironing the clothes. Sharpener with pencil, so we can write using the pencil. Next is microwave or oven. Scissor, so yes, first is watch needs electricity or not? Yes students, watch needs battery, not electricity. So next, they have given bicycle. If we want to use bicycle, what we need? Yes, we need air. Okay, if air is available, we can easy to use the cycle. Next is iron. If we want to use the iron, what we need? We need electricity. Yes, we need electricity. Then you have to click on the iron. Okay, yes, click on iron. Iron needs electricity. So next, what they have given? Sharpener with pencil. Okay, we don't need electricity to use pencil. So next is oven. If we want to use oven, what we need? We need electricity. So then we have to click on fifth. What is that? Oven. Okay, so next is scissor. Okay, we can cut the things. So we need electricity to use the scissor? No, we don't need. So this is the simple activity. So next we will go to the lesson. Yes, what is the first lesson? Yes, first lesson is starting and shutting down a computer. In this lesson we will learn how to start computer and how to shut down a computer. Okay, so computer is electronic machine. Yes, computer is electronic machine. Example for electronic machine, what are the different types, different example for electronic machine like TV, washing machine? These are the simple example for the electronic machine. We need electricity to use TV, washing machine, freezer. Okay, so fan, these are electronic machine. So next is like other machines. Say TV, it can be switched on and off. Yes, we will switch on, we will switch off the machines like TV, freezer, fans. So Likewise, we can also switch on and switch off the computer. Okay, so we will see. Switching on a computer is known as starting a computer. Okay, it has a different name. We cannot call switch on, switch off. Okay, so switching on a computer is nothing but starting a computer. Okay, so starting is nothing but switching on computer. So we have to say it as starting a computer. Okay, so next is, and switching off a computer is called shutting down a computer. Okay, so switching off a computer is called as shutting down a computer. Keep it in mind. Switching off a computer is called shutting down a computer, and switching on a computer is known as starting a computer. These are the different name for switching on a computer, okay, and switching off a computer. Yes, before starting a computer, let us understand how a computer is connected. How a computer is connected. So, yes, in all desktop computers, there is a wire that comes out from cabinet. When you look for the CPU box, that is cabinet, that wire will come out from the cabinet. This wire which comes out from the CPU box, that wire is connected to electrical switchboard. Yes, that wire is connected to electrical switchboard. Yes, next is, yes, you should know that sometimes the wire from the cabinet may be connected to a UPS. Here, UPS is nothing but, we have learned in the parts of computer. Okay. Yes, UPS is, what is the full form of UPS? Uninterrupted power supply. Okay, we learned in the parts of computer. Okay, UPS is also not a part of computer. It is external devices. Okay, it is not compulsory to use. Okay, when it is used, okay, here UPS is used when there is no electricity. It means it supplies the backup to the computer if electricity is not available. So an interrupted power supply is used to give backup power when there is no electricity. Okay, if you are using computer, suddenly electricity goes off. Okay, so you can use UPS. It means UPS provides, it supplies backup power to the computer. So it has a power button. It means if the CPU is connected to UPS, okay, if the CPU is connected to UPS, you have to on the UPS power button. Okay, so next is connection between the parts of a computer. How it will connect? See here, this is a CPU. Yes, this is what it is. It is CPU box. What it is? CPU box. So next it is UPS. What it is? UPS. Uninterrupted power supply. Okay. So it is monitor. What it is? It is monitor. Then what it is? Yes. Okay. It is keyboard. Then it is small size. What it is? It is mouse. So the wire which comes out from the CPU, that wire is connected to UPS. Okay. So this UPS is connected to switchboard and all other devices. Those devices are connected to CPU. Okay. All other devices are connected to CPU. Yes. What is next? This is cabinet or CPU box. Okay, what it is? It is cabinet or CPU box. CPU means what is the full form of CPU? Central processing unit. Okay, so it has another power button. If you look at here, okay, so this is the power button. This is the power button. Okay, so CPU box has another power button. Next is the monitor also has a power button. This is the power button of monitor. This is the power button of monitor. The monitor also needs to be connected to the power supply or the UPS. It also has power button. It also has power button. So next is switching on a computer. Switching on a computer is nothing but how to start a computer. Switching on a computer is nothing but starting a computer. These are the simple steps how to start a computer. First is switch on the main power button. Main power button, switchboard. Okay, the first computer is connected to switchboard. Okay, that one we have to on. That one we have to on. Okay, so switch on the main power supply button. If a UPS is connected, switch on the UPS power button instead. Okay, if your computer is connected to UPS, okay, that UPS will be connected to switchboard. Then you have to on the switchboard button first. You have to on the switchboard button. Next is you have to on the UPS power button. Okay, next is you have to on the UPS power button. If UPS is not connected to your computer, there is no need to on the UPS power button. So next is switch on the cabinet power button. Switch on the cabinet power button. See what they have given. Once the UPS is switched on, switch on the cabinet or CPU box power button. Okay, so next, finally, switch on the monitor power button. Okay, after the UPS, you have to on the cabinet. Okay, after that, on the monitor power button. Okay, so these are the simple steps how to start a computer. After starting the computer, what will happen? Yes, the computer takes some time to display the welcome screen when you start the computer. Okay, if you have computer at your home, just you try. Okay, when you start the computer, it takes some time to display the welcome screen. This is the welcome screen. This is the welcome screen. Yes. The computer takes some time to display the welcome screen, or we can also call it as logon screen. Okay, we can also call it as logon screen. During this time is nothing but when it takes some time. During this time, the computer cannot be used. Okay, the computer cannot be used. It performs many steps that make it ready for use. Okay, this process by which the computer gets ready for use is called booting. It performs many steps that make it ready for use. Okay, so that processing is called booting. Computer will take some time to get ready. So that process is called, what it is called? Booting. Okay, keep it in mind. So next is, yes, okay, after starting the computer, it will show the welcome screen or logon screen. After that, it will display all these things. We will learn what these are. Okay, this is the desktop. What it is? Desktop. It is called desktop. Okay, so next is C. The welcome screen indicates that the computer is ready to use. After logging in, the first screen that appears is called as desktop. Okay, after starting the computer, it will display the screen. This screen is called desktop. The small pictures on the desktop are called icons. You can see here these small pictures. Okay, these small pictures are called icons. Okay, these are called icons. Icons are nothing but small pictures on desktop. Okay, small pictures on desktop are called icons. Okay, so next is the button present on the lower left corner of the desktop screen. This is the desktop. Lower means bottom, bottom left side, bottom left side corner. This is the start button. Where it will be? Okay, so it will be left corner, lower left corner or bottom left corner. So it is start button. You can say here. Okay, you can see here. This is the start button. Okay, this is the start button. Where it will be? It will be lower left corner, lower left corner of the desktop. So next is the long horizontal bar at the bottom of screen. The long horizontal, okay, this is the horizontal line, this is the vertical line. Here you can see the horizontal line, this horizontal bar, okay, this horizontal bar at the bottom of the screen of the desktop, what it is called, which bar it is? It is called taskbar. What it is called? Taskbar. Keep it in mind. So okay, just I will revise you. So icons are nothing but small pictures on the desktop. Okay, icons are nothing but small pictures on the desktop. Next is the screen. When you start the computer, it will show the welcome screen. After that, it will show the a particular screen. That screen is called desktop. Next is the start button. Okay, the start button which appears. Okay, it will be in the lower left side corner. Lower left side corner and the horizontal bar. It will be the bottom of desktop. That bar is called taskbar. Okay, students. So next is, yes, this is the, these are the simple steps how to shut down a computer. Shutdown is nothing but switching off the computer, but you have to say shutting down a computer, shut down a computer. So first step is click on the start button. Yes, in the last slide you have seen how start button looks. Where will be the start button? Yes, it will be the bottom or lower side corner, lower left side corner. Okay, it will be in the taskbar. Okay, just you have to click on the start button. Next is click on the shutdown button. When you click on the start button, it will display the start menu. Okay, it will display the start menu. In that menu, the shutdown button option will be there. Okay, just you have to click on the shutdown button. Okay, so next step 3, switch off the monitor power button. Okay, third step is switch off the monitor power button. Fourth step is switch off the UPS power button. After the monitor, you have to switch off the UPS. I think you have to understood. After monitor, you have to off the CPU power button. But when you off the when you click on the shutdown button, CPU will get automatically off. Okay, there is no need to off the CPU power button. So next is after CPU, there is no need to off the CPU button. When you click on the shutdown button, automatically CPU will get off. So after that, you have to off the monitor power button. After that, switch off the UPS power button. If your computer is connected to UPS, you have to off the UPS power button. If the if a computer is not connected to UPS, there is no need to off the UPS directly. You have to off the main power supply button. Okay, these are the simple steps how to shut down a computer. Next slide, it will show when you click on the start button. This is the start button. Okay, when you click on the start button, the start menu will display. These are the menus. Okay, these are the menus. So when you click on the start button, here you can see this is the shutdown option. This is the shutdown option. So you have to click on shutdown button. Yes, you have to click on shutdown button. Then automatically CPU will get off. After that, you have to off the monitor. Then if the computer is connected to UPS, off the UPS. After that, you have to off main power supply button. These are the simple steps how to off the, in the sense how to shut down a computer. Okay students, just I will revise today what we have learned. Yes, we learned in the first topic is what is a computer. Okay, so how to start a computer, connection between the computer, UPS, what is the use of UPS, and steps how to start a computer. After starting a computer, what it will display. Okay, like logon screen, we can also call it as a welcome screen. Okay, so next, after starting the computer, it will display welcome screen. After that, it will display screen. That screen is called desktop. And what are the different things available on the desktop, like icons, taskbar. Okay, so these are the simple examples. So next, what we have learned, how to shut down a computer. Okay students, I hope you understood. In the next class, we will learn new lesson. Okay, thank you.